Hallo Tokio!
Hey!
We have some questions in the comment sections on YouTube that we are going to answer today. First, some training related questions. Do you think there is much benefit to using a training mask? Have you noticed a measurable difference?
I think there's a lot of benefit if you want to do long efforts on threshold power. Because on threshold power, you should be able to breathe easily, deep in, deep out. Once you start to hyperventilate, it's really hard to sustain this threshold pace. And with the training mask, you can simulate the thresholds breathing at a really low pace.
During a time trial, do you like the directeur sportif to shout in your ear the whole time? Do you listen to music? Do you get information?
The first, let's say, 60 to 70% of the time trial, I want real constructive information, like corners coming up, my split times, just real informative information, and then in the final part, they can go loco.
What's your current crank length, and have you ever tried longer and shorter?
When I just started as a cyclist, as an under 23 cyclist, I used 172.5, but now I'm always riding with 170 cranks, road bike, time trial bike, whatever.
My eyeballs hurt when I spent a lot of time on the TT.
It's important to warm up your eyeballs during the activation session. And they will hurt, you will get a bit dizzy of long time in TT position, but that's just part of the game.
In order to check your position, do you ever ride in front of a mirror, film yourself or anything else?
I just know what my position is. I have some points that I can focus on to remember my position. Sometimes I try to look a bit in the mirror, or when you're riding in a shopping street, of course you look in every window to check your style.
Do you train intervals in your position, like 5 minutes in the position, 5 minutes relax?
Once I start time trialing after a long period without riding the bike, I always try to build it up. Like you say, I would maybe start with 5 minutes in, 5 minutes out, 10 minutes in, 5 minutes out, 15 minutes in, 5 minutes out, up to 2 hours in, 1 minute out, 2 hours in, something like this.
Why are you taking cold showers? And what's the effect?
So the effect of cold showers, you feel alive after this cold shower. You jump in the shower, you're out of the shower right away. You don't spend hours in the shower and you feel, now I'm ready for the day, or I'm ready for... After your training ride, you feel recovered a lot faster.
If you take a cold shower, do you feel like your dick is ready for some action?
I don't know if this is a real question, but... It can happen that your dick is decreasing from size a little bit, but after it's getting a lot bigger than it was before.
That's why you take the cold showers. What's that crazy breathing device you use sometimes?
I use a power breath some days, let's say 3 days a week, and then 3 days a week I use my training mask.
Some food related questions. Do you use any protein supplements? Or is the amount in the vegan food enough?
The amount of proteins you get in is also good when you are vegan. But it might be interesting to get some supplementary BCAAs, amino acids, the important amino acids. Because when you're vegan, not all the proteins you get have all the amino acids.
Dry spoke or deep rim? What's faster?
The testing I did is that a deep rim is faster, but it's always difficult because you are testing. If you want to know which wheel is the fastest, you go to the track, because some I have not seen a tri-spoke yet that is ready for tubeless. So it can be that a tri-spoke tubeless wheel is faster than a deep tubeless wheel. It's quite hard to do the testing because in the wind tunnel you know aerodynamically which wheel is the fastest, but you want the fastest wheel in total, so the tire is included also.
What type of Garmin are you using, and what type of Garmin wearable are you using?
I use an Edge 830 most of the time when I'm riding the bike. I have an itch 130 for the climbing stages. I have an itch 1030 when I use a lot of navigation. And my wearable is like the Fenix 5X. It's not the most recent Fenix there is, but it's more than suitable for the things I use it for. It's mostly recording my my sauna sessions, my core sessions, and my sleep data.
Would you uplift your TT bars to a more praying mantis position if it was UCI legal?
I did testing this year in October with totally not UCI legal positions to see what might be really beneficial. And there was not a real, real big advantage. Happy about that.
Is a 23 millimeter tire, front tire, more aerodynamic, even if your rim is a wide rim?
A narrow tire is really aerodynamic, but rolling resistance is also important. What you see sometimes in team time trials, because in team time trials the average is most of the time closer to 60 than to 50. You see that in team time trials, sometimes a narrow tire is used on the front wheel to really be aero with the first thing that hits the wind. But in general, when you do a time trial at 50k an hour or lower than 50k an hour, it's faster to have a 25 millimeter or even a 27 millimeter tire, because it's such a small difference in aerodynamics, but a real big difference in rolling resistance.
Okay, same setup, completely the same setup, but only difference is rim brake or disc brake. What's faster?
What's faster?
Aerodynamically.
Aerodynamically, most of the time, disc brake is faster. Can be that a rim brake tests faster in the wind tunnel, but the disc brake make sure the clearance of the tire in the fork is bigger at both sides, so the wheel is spinning more easily. There is less resistance for the wheel to spin, which makes the bike more faster in total.
Do you know if a stiff frame and a non or less stiff frame makes a big difference? So like a bicycle that is 2 or 3 years old, would you lose a lot of...
That's really hard to measure. Accelerations are really hard to measure, and stiffness is really important when you're accelerating. When you are just doing a time trial Ironman pace, let's say 300 watts all the time, stiffness is not that important. But when you are going into a sprint world tour level and you're pushing close to 2000 watts, stiffness is really important. I personally do feel the difference between a frame that I'm training on for over 1 year compared to a frame that is brand new. I do feel the difference in accelerating out of the corners.
The Garmin mount you are using on your BMC SLR-1 doesn't look like the standard thing. It looks more robust. Where did you get it?
I don't know. This is what was on the bike once I got it from the team. I think it's a special BMC Garmin mount, because it's mounted under the stem, so I don't think it's provided by any